Hi, welcome back to the channel. My name is Molly and today at Live UTI Free, we're chatting with Mary Cotter about recurrent UTIs. If you're new to our channel, be sure to check out the description below as we've linked to other resources that you might find helpful. Lastly, if you enjoy these videos, think they're important and want to support what we do, be sure to hit subscribe and tick the bell so you get notified when we post new videos. And other than that, we hope these videos provide the insights you need to take the next step on your UTI recovery journey. So joining us today is Mary Cotter. Thank you for taking the time to share your experience around recurrent UTIs in this Clinician Insights series. Firstly, can you tell us a little bit about yourself, where you're based, and how you become a nutritional therapist?
Sure, yeah. So my name's Mary. I'm currently based in Scotland in the UK. I'm actually in the process of moving to Ireland, so soon that will be changing. And I am a nutritional therapist. I became a nutritional therapist, not really through choice, but through my journey and experience with chronic UTIs and numerous different problems with urinary health, and that led me to switching careers from interiors to becoming a nutritional therapist. And that was about 10 years ago, and at that point when I retrained, I would describe it as being quite a traumatic experience. And initially, I wasn't quite ready to talk about my experience and my journey. And I started out specializing in irritable bowel syndrome, IBS, gut health. And it was really only in the last few years where I decided, actually, you know, I do feel ready now to open up and talk. It's just heartbreaking to see how many people are still struggling, going through a similar experience to what I did. And I just feel it just felt like a right time to really focus down and specialize in chronic UTI, interstitial cystitis, urinary health, bladder pain symptoms. So all of that really is where I love to help people.
Yeah, that's great. So what type of patients do you see with recurrent and chronic UTIs?
So it's mainly women. They can be from all different ages, from, early 20s right up to menopause and beyond. But everybody is experiencing something along the lines of, I had a UTI, went to the doctor, had some antibiotics, but, the symptoms didn't change. Mm-hmm. Then you kind of go round all the houses, mm-hmm. gynecology, urogyne, urology, and they end up, sort of being fobbed off or told they've got interstitial cystitis or chronic bladder pain syndrome. And mm-hmm. then they're sort of left Googling and wondering, oh my God, is my life going to feel like this forever? Mm-hmm. And that's typically when they find me, and that's that's typically then when we would kind of dive into their health history, what they've tried so far, look at the testing that they've had up until now, and just see where we can start to change direction and really look at the root cause and identify what's actually at the heart of that chronic bladder pain. Mm-hmm. That's typically the type of person I generally work with.
Okay. So what is your typical approach when you meet someone with recurrent UTIs?
So initially, we kind of take a quite detailed health history to see what they've been through, other underlying health issues. So exploring, gut health, stress, nervous system, mm-hmm. hormonal balance, all of those things. But I've created a framework to sort of take us on a journey through all the different systems in the body that really benefit from support and rebalance. So the first step is retesting. And the reason for that is, as your community may be already aware of, but there's so many limitations with dipstick tests and culture tests. And certainly in the UK and Ireland, you know, that's what they will have had through their doctors, through their urologists. And what I offer my clients is more advanced testing using PCR and NGS, where we're looking at the genetic material, but also the overall balance of bacteria in the urinary bladder. Because what we're now aware of is that actually, like any other microbiome in the body, like the gut microbiome or the vaginal microbiome, the urinary bladder also has its own microbiome, which is made up of bacteria. And that can be friendly bacteria, it can be bacteria that can change direction depending on, you know, how stressed you are or how healthy you are. And then yes, also there will be pathogenic bacteria at times also. So it's looking at, I want to know what's going on in that environment, not just looking at the bad pathogens, but also looking at the friendly microbes and supporting the health of those, because they're also involved in preventing repeat infection and bladder flares. You know, they're involved in, you know, they form part of the immune system and produce lactic acid to prevent pathogen growth. So they're something that's of great interest. That's why we use the testing. And with those results, then it can help remove some of the guesswork and help us prioritize what the next step in that journey needs to be. Does it need to be antimicrobials, or would we be better off focusing on probiotics that are targeted to the urinary system? Or do we need to look at the immune side of things and really support, you know, vitamin D and their stress levels and nervous system health? So the program I offer clients, the Heal Your Bladder program, generally takes people on through each step on that framework, generally at least, you know, initially 6 months. Some people respond really quickly. For others, it might be a slightly different journey where we use different testing as well. But that's generally how it works.
Okay. And how do you work with other consultants in this process?
So if a client requires further medical support, I do have a network of private doctors who I refer to. There's access to private prescriptions and consultations. So whether they need medical support or nutritional support, they absolutely have a choice in which direction they go. So as a nutritional therapist, my role is about supporting the individual. So the diagnosis would be through their doctor or urologist. What my role is about creating balance and supporting that individual as a whole. So we don't just fixate on the bladder or the vagina or the fact that they've got bloating. We're looking at the overall picture and piecing it together, rather than, you know, a doctor's approach is slightly different. They're really fixating on the bladder and maybe overlooking what's going on in the vagina, which could actually be influencing when a bladder flares or, you know, different episodes of symptoms.
That's really interesting. What is your typical treatment approach when you identify the infection, or when you don't identify an infection?
So we use the PCR test results as a screening tool. It's a helpful guide to determine, okay, do we need to actually start some antimicrobials, or is it a case that actually it's the opportunistic bacteria that are slightly out of balance, and what we need to do is actually help crowd them out by going in with more of the good friendly bacteria. And from there, we then work on supporting their immune health so that their defenses are really robust. You know, you do have to ask yourself, if you're somebody with recurring UTIs or recurring bladder flares, why does that keep happening? Why isn't the immune system responding appropriately? And how can we help ourselves, you know, through food, through supplements, mm-hmm. through diet? And the other important step is nervous system health, because that is, and I know you've talked about this before on other videos, but pelvic floor function and hypertonic pelvic floor plays into our pain scores and mm-hmm. the severity of our pain. And we can use food and specific minerals and nutrients to have a really nice calming effect on the body. And that's a really important adjunct to having pelvic floor therapy. So again, it's, you know, looking beyond just the burning symptoms and mm-hmm. looking at how can we help this person calm their nervous system, relax the muscles. And again, that's quite a sensitive topic, because so many of us have sort of been, you know, it may have been suggested to you that, oh, you just need to relax, you know, you're just mm-hmm. stressed, it'll all go away, just chill out. But actually, many of us, we're in fight or flight a lot of the time. You know, we're at our laptops, Googling for answers. Having a chronic health condition is very stressful. Yeah. So anything we can do to try and calm and relax and reset is also going to help change how we respond to things and how our pain scores respond as well. So mm-hmm. that also forms quite a big important step in mm-hmm. that kind of recovery process.
I think a lot of our community deal with that. So it's the stress of not knowing where to go next when you're dealing with these chronic UTIs. So I think having that is really important.
Definitely.
Yeah. So you mentioned gut and vaginal health. Do you have any tips on preventing future UTIs?
So I've got a lot of tips. Some you'll find on my website. I have a free ebook that you're welcome to download called Heal Your Bladder. But what I would suggest as a starting point is looking at foods, first of all, and mm-hmm. a few obvious places to start would be things like blueberries, which are really rich in polyphenols that have also shown to interfere with how certain bacteria adhere to the lining of the urethra. So we've probably all heard about cranberry, but blueberries also contain similar polyphenols that work in a similar way. And often I find they're just easier to fit into the diet. Pumpkin seeds are also a great one for symptoms like urgency, frequency, and they're just a nice thing to incorporate quite easily in food to support urinary health. The other big thing that I focus in on with clients as part of my program is vitamin D testing. Yeah. Vitamin D is really, really key, because if you are prone to infections, having optimal levels, not just scraping by with like, okay, you're not deficient, but you know, mm-hmm. it's not amazing. It does play an integral part to the risk of recurrence of UTI. So making sure you're either supplementing through the winter months, there is trace amounts of vitamin D in food, but we're really relying on sun exposure and exposing our skin to the sun. But again, most of us, like, we're indoors a lot of the time. So foods, you know, eggs, mushrooms, oily fish would have small amounts of vitamin D there. And the other thing to consider then would be, you know, those probiotics, and looking at foods that will naturally provide a source. And again, depending on where you are in that journey, they may or may not be suitable straight away. You'd maybe need to start slowly with them, but a few examples would be like homemade kefir, raw sauerkraut, beetroot kraut, miso paste. And again, you know, just going really slowly with them, but that would be a way of getting some of these probiotics through food. But I guess the beauty of working with a nutritional therapist is that we are uniquely trained in the use of supplements, and we would be able to tailor a plan for you depending on like what your symptoms are. Is it a chronic UTI? Is it a recurring UTI picture? Like it would really vary depending on what that person is presenting with. It's not really kind of, here is a probiotic, it'll work for everything. Unfortunately, they would kind of be a few things. And certainly like in terms of immune health, thinking about zinc also, zinc is in a lot of nuts, seeds, quinoa, lamb, shellfish. It's really important for immune health. And that's kind of where I would, you know, if you're at home wondering what you can do, that's kind of an easy place to start.
Yeah, no, that's amazing. Thank you. That's some really interesting tips. So how can patients get in touch with you?
So you'll find me on Instagram mainly. I'm at marycotter.nutrition. My website is marycotternutrition.com. Please feel free to get in touch through my website. And don't be shy, drop me a DM on Instagram. I'd love to connect with you and share some resources with you and help get you started. And the last thing I just want to say on the diet side of things is that many of the people who come to work with me are coming really from a place of fear and anxiety around food. And that was my experience as well, way back when I was going through this. You know, you go online and you think, oh, avoid anything acidic. You've got to avoid tomatoes, citrus, all of that. And I think a really key turning point on my journey was when I was working with a nutritionist, helping me understand actually a food's pH changes on digestion and it's metabolized in the body. So I think what I really want to get across is please don't fear food. That's actually the very thing that's going to help you get stronger, build up your defenses, and respond well. If all you're doing is cutting out foods and fearing, chances are you're going to lose weight, become depleted, and actually feel much worse. And again, I dive into that in more detail on my website and on Instagram.
Okay, that's amazing. Well, thank you, Mary, for providing us with some valuable information on the nutritional perspective connection in recurrent UTIs. We will include your details in the description below for anyone who would like to get in contact. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you found this video helpful. You're always welcome to reach out to us for more information about clinicians who specialise in recurrent and chronic UTI. Our contact is in the description below. If you'd like to learn more about this or related topics, be sure to check out our other videos or head over to liveutifree.com for other articles on recurrent UTI treatment options. Of course, if you like what we're doing on the channel, make sure to hit the subscribe button here on YouTube and tick the bell so you get notifications about future videos. Thanks so much for joining us for our Clinician Insight series. If you have suggestions for who we should interview next, be sure to drop us a comment.